station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Sandra Jones. This week, a cargo resupply vehicle arrived to the space station, and astronauts prepare to venture outside the hatch into the vacuum of space for a spacewalk. On Monday, Northrop Grumman's CRS-15 cargo resupply vehicle, named the SS Katherine Johnson, in honor of the legendary NASA mathematician, arrived to the space station carrying over 4 tons of science investigations, cargo, and crew supplies. CRS-15 launched from the Wallops Flight Facility in Wallops, Virginia, on Saturday, February 20th, and was captured with the station's robotic arm by JAXA astronaut Soichi Noguchi, and then installed to the station's Earth-facing side of the Unity module, where it will remain until late May. Science investigations on board this Cygnus include Micro-16, which is an investigation studying muscle strength changes in worms to help us better understand muscle weakening that astronauts can experience in microgravity. Lam Davison's second experiment headed to the space station to study the advantages of manufacturing artificial retinas in space. And AHOS, a radiation detection system developed for the Orion spacecraft and certified for use on NASA's Artemis II mission, the first Artemis mission on which a crew of astronauts will orbit the moon in the spacecraft. On Sunday, February 28th, 2 spacewalkers will begin work for upcoming solar array upgrades. NASA astronauts Kate Rubins and Victor Glover will work together to begin assembling and installing modification kits required for solar array upgrades during Sunday's spacewalk. Though they are functioning well, the current set of solar arrays are showing signs of degradation, which was expected. 6 new solar arrays are scheduled for delivery to the station during 3 resupply missions starting later this year. Each new array will produce more than 20 kilowatts of electricity. You can tune in to watch the spacewalk, the third for both Rubens and Glover, on NASA TV and the agency's website. Live coverage will begin at 4:30 a.m. Eastern. That's Space to Ground for this week. Thanks for watching. As always, keep sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.